first speaker is Anna. Anna, and she is an developer advocate in Amadeus. And Anna will present to us why you need a developer relations team for your API. Hello, Anna.
Hello, Leon. Thanks for the intro.
Can you share my screen?
Yes. Can you see it properly?
Yeah, thank you. So I leave the stage to you. Thank you.
Perfect, thank you. So hello everyone, and thank you very much for joining today's talk. Before introducing myself, I would like to do and to share with you a small story. So a few years ago, my best friend and I wanted to develop a blog website in order to share the articles and stories that we were writing. And we decided to use some analytics API provider in order to know more information about the traffic and the visitors that we had in our web page. So we started working with one API provider, and since the very beginning, we didn't have a good developer experience. The documentation was not very clear. There were not enough tutorials and guides to help us get started. And it was really hard also to find some technical people in the team to share our feedback. So after weeks of frustration, we decided to move to another API provider that was giving a better developer experience for us. So my name is Anna Tsolakou, and I work as a developer advocate at Amadeus for Developers. For the ones who are not very familiar with Amadeus, Amadeus is the leader technical provider in travel, and Amadeus for Developers is the open API program of Amadeus that we offer travel data and services to the developers across the world. And today I would like to talk about why you need a developer relations team for your API. And I'm sure you have heard a lot of stories similar to the ones I shared at the beginning. And this is very, very relevant to how the market looks like today. So today there are a lot of APIs per industry that they provide very good technology and services. But providing a quality API is the minimum you can offer to your customers. Your customers have many more expectations, such as developer tools to reduce the technical complexity, tutorials and guides, and even a developer community around your product. And this is exactly where the developer relations team fits, and we believe that this team can make you a big player in the market. And what is a developer relations team, or DevRel, that you might have heard? I'm sure you're familiar with a lot of different names and roles, like developer evangelist, advocates, technical writers, technical ambassadors, etc. And actually, there is a lot of debate out there about what is really developer relations and who of all these roles fits into DevRel team. And the truth is that it's all DevRel. If you take into consideration the developer experience, you will notice that developer experience is diverse, and your customers, all these developers, have different needs. So it's very important to build a diverse team with different skills and different backgrounds. For example, maybe you can have some members who are more confident in public speaking, or other DevRel members that are more into coding, etc. And the developer relations team is all about understanding developers, understanding your users and what they want to build, and how also you can help them be successful, and how they really feel about your APIs. And the DevRel team fills the gap between the API and your customers. So the role of DevRel team internally is to raise the voice of the customers, to share their feedback. And externally, it's going to be the public face of your API. It's going to be the team that represents your technology. And something very critical about developer relations is that all its members need to wear different hats. And by that, I mean that they're involved in many different roles and many different tasks, and they have to adapt quickly to any changes. At Amadeus for Developers, since the beginning of our program, we identified three main reasons why we need a developer relations team for our API. The first one is about developer experience. How we can ensure that our customers can integrate easily and efficiently our APIs in their own applications. And then it's about developer community. How we can build a developer community that brings awareness and adoption of our APIs, and how we can also create engagement long-term with this community. And finally, one of the main reasons is about the feedback process. How we can have a smooth feedback process, how we can ensure that we take properly the feedback of our customers and we pass it smoothly internally in the company so we can build an attractive roadmap. So today I would like to talk about these three main reasons and to see how actually the developer relations team fits, and also I'm going to share some best practices. And let's start with the developer experience. Now, when a developer wants to use an API, is expecting to have a reduced technical complexity because every developer is working with different technologies and different programming languages. That's why a very big role of the DevRel team to provide these tools that are called SDKs. So SDKs that are software development kits are all the libraries that contain tools and documentation to help your customers build their applications and integrate APIs easily. For example, someone who is building Android application is going to expect some Android SDK. So through the SDK, you give immediate access to your APIs in the programming language and programming environment of your customer. You can also help them have a simple authorization process. And finally, something else that you can offer is error handling. So every time the application that they build crashes and they want to do debugging, with proper error handling, you can help them a lot, reduce the complexity of the debugging process. And we ran an experiment with a senior developer to see the power of the SDKs. So one senior developer made one API call without any SDK at first. And he wrote almost 60 lines of code in 10 minutes. But when he used our SDK, he spent only 3 minutes and he wrote 10 lines of code for that. And as I mentioned before, this developer that we did the experiment with is a senior developer, someone who has experience and was not the first time doing that. So imagine someone who just gets started with APIs, how much more time and effort would have spent. And also, you have to take into consideration that your customers are not going to use only your API. For example, someone who is making a hotel booking application is not going to use only APIs related to travel, but also APIs related to payment, APIs related to analytics, to maps, etc. So they're really going to appreciate if you give them the right tools and libraries to reduce the technical complexity. And now let's have a look at the documentation and guides. First of all, the documentation that you offer is the official API reference and overview of your technology. And you have to make sure that it's consistent and clear, especially in companies that the APIs come from different development teams. It's very probable that there are inconsistencies and that every team is using different vocabulary and ways of documenting. So the role of the DevRel team is to make sure that everything is consistent, clear, and to hear the feedback of the customers to improve the documentation. And also, your customers have a wide variety of experience and industry knowledge. That's why it's very important to provide some educational content to them, such as technical guides, functional guides, or even some video tutorials to explain some complex processes step by step. And to show you the power of the guides and educational content in general, So at the beginning of our program, when the developer relations team was smaller, most of the content that we were sharing was promotional. But then when the DevRel team started to grow, we reached a point that 80% of our content is educational content. And as you can see, since we started having more educational content, we reached a point where we have more than 300% monthly visitors. So these numbers really show that our customers, or even people who are interested in our technology, really like the educational and more technical content. And another role and contribution from the developer relations team is about demo applications. So by demo applications, you can inspire and give ideas to your customers of what they can build with your technology. And also you can reduce a lot the onboarding process by providing them some prototypes and demos that you also share the code with them. And also, this is a very good way to bring awareness and promote your APIs. And what we do in our case, we think of some use cases that we want to show, and also some APIs that we want to include, some new APIs that we released, or even some older APIs that our customers don't really know the power of them. And also what we do is we make sure that these projects are open source. So as I mentioned before, you can help your customers have a faster onboarding process, and also you can help them get started. And this is very useful for companies such as early stage startups that they already have an idea, but you want to boost more their idea and their business by giving them some use cases and inspiration. And also for some potential customers. So every time you talk with someone about your technology, you can very easily show some demos in order to show them what type of APIs you provide. And finally, these applications are used a lot by hackathon attendees and students that they want to get started quickly and build something small in a limited amount of time. And to show you two examples of demo applications that the DevRel team has built, on the first side, you can see this map that has different hotels in the city. And for every hotel, there is some information about how safe is the area around this location, and also some attractions that a traveler can visit. And on the other side, on the right side, you can see a flight search, but it's not a typical flight search. It's actually a flight search using artificial intelligence APIs that sorts the flights not by price, but by the probability of them to be booked. And also we predict if the traveler who's doing the search is traveling for business or for holidays. So these are just two examples of applications that we build, and we make them open source and share with the developer community. And now let's talk about customer support. Customer support plays also a significant role of the developer relations team. When you think about customer support, you can think of all the requests and questions that your customers have. And when it comes to developers, most of the cases, the questions that they have are technical questions and functional questions. And the DevRel team is the one that has the expertise, not only in the APIs and the technical side, but also in the industry. So it really makes sense to have developer advocates support the customer support process. And also something that we think is really valuable and we do as DevRel is to build a framework that checks the health of your API. Because you want to make sure that you identify any issues and bugs before your customers do. And also, it's very important to keep in mind that developers are not only going to reach you out on the official support email, but developers live in many different online places like Stack Overflow, GitHub, Twitter, etc. So make sure that you're active and responsive in all these channels as well, for a better customer experience. And finally, customer support is a great source of feedback. So not only you talk every day with a lot of customers to understand their needs, what they want to build, and their struggles, but also you get a very good understanding of the market trends by seeing all these applications that they try to build. And now let's talk about developer community. So developer community, and especially how to engage with the developer community, is one of the top priorities of the developer relations team. So we identify different type of events that we attend very frequently. One of them is hackathons. So hackathons are events that they bring a lot of awareness, because in hackathons, there are hundreds of attendees that they have the chance to learn and use your API. And also it's very, very interesting because you get in contact with many different profiles, like junior developers, data scientists, even designers, and you see how they really feel about your product from the registration until the end of the hackathon that they have built something. So this is a very good way to gain feedback from many different points of views. And also we very often go to different conferences and meetups, because we are not only interested to gain knowledge and learn different type of things about technology, the industry, or APIs, but we're always very happy when we have the chance to share our knowledge and our experience to other people. And also, of course, this leads to networking as well as taking some feedback about our product. And something that I'm going to mention a bit in more detail later is an online community for developers. So we realized that we have been talking with customers and potential customers in many different places, and we didn't have a single place for all these users. So we decided to build an online community, so whoever is interested can join this community to ask for support or do some networking. And I'm going to talk about it a bit later in more detail. And one advice that we as DevRels want to give is embrace open source. All the demo applications that you might build and the developer tools that you provide, you can have them public and open source, because developers love using open source technologies and they love contributing to them. Every time a developer sees an interesting project, most probably is going to contribute to this project, especially if it's something that is also using. And this can build a lot of trust with your customers and the developer community overall. And some numbers about last year's regarding developer community. In 2019, with the work we did around events, we reached more than 6,000 audience. So we went to 21 conferences and events. We went to 6 hackathons, where 2 of them actually were organized by Amadeus for developers. And also we gave 17 talks on different conferences and meetups. And now a few more details about the online developer community that I mentioned before. So as I said, we wanted to have one single place for everyone who is interested in our APIs to be able to join. And we also are able to give them support whenever they have any questions. So in order to make this community that we built more interesting for them, we came up with some activities. So actually this channel is pretty new. It started a few months ago, and since then it has been growing. And regarding the activities, first of all, we have scheduled some support hours. So every time we have support hours, we make sure that some people can have questions and they can come to us and ask their questions they might have or the struggles while they use our APIs. And also we have some networking hours where just people can join and they can have different types of technical or industry related discussions. And also every time we find an interesting article, we make sure that we share it with the community. And actually the results were pretty interesting since the beginning of this community. Only from the first week, we had a lot of interactions with the users, especially for support hours. We thought that maybe no one would join, but in the end, there were a lot of members that joined and shared with us questions and feedback that they had. And we also had one user who contributed to our SDKs. Also, another user decided to build a project using our APIs and also share it with the community. And finally, one user wrote a blog article, and we shared this article in our blog section. And finally, let's have a look at the feedback. So something that we really wanted to do at Amadeus for Developers, we wanted to make sure that we are able to collect user feedback. And actually, through all this work we have done about customer support and developer community, we realized that it's very, very easy to gain developer feedback. So through all the customer support channels, every day we take a lot of feedback and we hear a lot of things coming from our users. And the same happens when it comes to events like hackathons and different types of conferences and the online developer community, because exactly we have this daily communication with our users or people who are just interested in our technology and they want to find out more. And also something that you can do in case you have a specific feedback, you can always create some surveys and send them to your customers, or you can even get in touch with them to have a call to know more information. And one of the main challenges that we identified was, okay, we're able to take a lot of user feedback, but how can we share this feedback internally in order to share it properly with engineering teams and product teams, and how we can consolidate this feedback? So we realized it really makes sense to invest a tool for that, so we can make the process as much as scalable as possible and as much as automated as it can be. So in our case, we started using Trello, the project management tool. So every time we hear some user feedback, we make sure we add all this feedback and all this information in this board, and also we use some metadata like proper labeling and tagging in order to be able to share it properly with the other teams and also prioritize it. And for now, it's something that works good and works way better than having just a long document or feedback in many different places that you can eventually lose. And something that we always do, every time we implement a feedback coming from a user, we make sure that this we get back to the users and we say, hi, thanks for your feedback. By the way, we implemented this. Thank you very much. It's something that the customers really appreciate. So to recap, today we talked about why you need a developer relations team for your API. And we talked about the three main reasons why having a DevRel team for your API can bring a lot of value to your program. So we talked about developer experience. We talked about all the contributions that the DevRel team can do for the developer experience regarding the customer support, SDKs, and demo applications, and also about technical guides and documentation. Then we talked about developer community, how we can build a developer community and how we can engage long-term with this community. So we talked about all the types of events that the DevRel team is going, and also the online developer community as a single place for all our users that we created. And finally, we talked about feedback, how we can collect the feedback coming from our customers and how we can share and consolidate this feedback internally so we can make an attractive product roadmap.
Okay, thank you, Anna.
Yeah. do I have 1 minute?
Yeah. I think we have time for one quick question. And I can see Dave have a very good questions here. He would like to know what kind of skills would you looking for if you are going to interview someone for a developer advocate position?
Okay, yeah, so this is a very interesting question. So one thing that someone who wants to work as DevRel or someone who wants to interview developer relations, something very important is to have the empathy and understanding of developers. Because as a developer advocate, you are constantly going to care about how the customers feel about your product and your technology. So for me, having empathy and understanding is very important. Also, as I mentioned before, wearing different hats, because if you expect as a DevRel to just do only one thing, like only coding or only public speaking, this is not enough. So you have to be motivated to play with different things and different roles. And finally, something very important is to, as a DevRel, not to forget that at the end of the day, DevRels are developers and they have technical background. So you always need to have interest in training and learning more about technology, so the customers you're talking with can feel more trust with you. Because as we know, developers feel trust talking with people that they have good technical background and good technical knowledge.
Okay, thank you, Anna. You have made a very, very great presentation on developer relations. And you may stop share your screen and leave the stage now. Thank you.
Thank you.